Get ready! You're tuned in to Tea Time Unfiltered with your girl, Lovely T, bringing you the hottest trending topics on social media. Stay connected. Instagram.com/LovelyT2002.
Hey everyone, I hope you guys are doing good. Happy Friday, TGIF. I know it's been a long week. It's also Friday the 13th, but you know, we're gonna, you know, not pay that too much attention. It's been a long week. It's been a lot of stuff going on with the coronavirus. I haven't been able to podcast because I've been doing live streams focusing on that. But once again, welcome to Tea Time Unfiltered with your girl, Lovely T. I'm glad you guys could join me today. And I hope, you know, this podcast ends up entertaining you and relaxing you on your car ride home, bus ride, you know, just wherever, okay? So anyways, I want to come on here and talk about the whole Corey Feldman situation. So as you guys all know, I was looking forward to being able to watch his long-awaited documentary. The documentary was called My Truth, and in this documentary, you had to pay $20 on his website to be able to see the stream. He also premiered it out in LA. He had a screening party. And so the day that it was supposed to drop, which was 4 days ago, people started texting me like, T, are you watching the documentary? I'm like, okay, well, the website has been up, but I'm not hearing anything play. We're hitting refresh. It's saying site unavailable. Honey, it was such a mess. And then come to find out, word on the streets is that basically somebody with money paid to have a DDoS attack on Corey Feldman's server. So for those of y'all who are not into IT, basically they had somebody hack the site and make it where it could not stream. People couldn't go on there. I mean, it was all types of error messages. It was a hot mess, honey, okay? So then what ended up happening is that basically the next day, I went on there to try and watch it again. Still couldn't get on. The site was up, but it wouldn't stream. I ended up finding somebody on YouTube who had streamed the entire thing. But the only thing is when you watched it, it was like kind of slow. It kind of lagged. So I mainly paid attention to the audio. But I did watch the whole hour, but I more or less listened to it because to watch it was so annoying because like the voice didn't match the people talking. And, you know, it was just a hard watch. But, you know, I'm still grateful that somebody did upload it onto YouTube. So nonetheless, basically it boils down to this. When he did the documentary, he basically didn't reveal anything new that I and many other people who have followed the two Coreys and this whole situation didn't already know. Okay, so this is what I posted on Instagram the day after the documentary came out. I stated this: Corey Feldman alleges that Charlie Sheen abused Corey Haimes in his Truth documentary. He alleges that it was on the set of Lucas back in 1985 when Haimes would have been 13 and Sheen would have been 19. Sheen is at the top of the list in those being named in the documentary, but there were others accused by Feldman in the movie. Others supported the story, saying that Haimes had told them all individually that Sheen raped them. Susan Sprague, Feldman's ex-wife, who starred in the two Coreys on their A&E sitcom / reality television series, says the same thing about the alleged abuse that Sheen took out on Corey. Others named in Feldman's documentary are people he has accused of sexually molesting him before, including John Grisham, an actor who appeared alongside the two Coreys in License to Drive and Dream a Little Dream. Feldman also once again accused nightclub owner Alfie Hoffman of sexual abuse, as well as his former talent manager, Marty Weiss, who was responsible for casting children in quite a few Paramount TV sitcoms in the late 70s and early 80s. Feldman also claims that Dominic Brasca had sexually abused Corey as well. So then basically I go on to say this. Long story short, he basically revealed what many of us tea sippers already knew. Also, many in the truth community have already called this out over the past few years. I still remember Corey liking tweets that called out these people. And then I went on to say, by the way, Alfie Hoffman was a frontman for a lot of deviant stuff. Back in the 80s, his teen club, the Soda Pop Club, had already been exposed by the truth community before YouTube shut them down and deleted the videos. Basically, had you done any research on the two Coreys, none of these names are shocking. I basically wasted $20 and I still haven't seen the movie. Any thoughts? So then at that point, we had a really good discussion on Instagram. So to this day, legend has it, anybody who paid $20 has still not had access to the movie, okay? So I don't know. Some people are giving Corey the side eye. Some people are like, you know, was this just a scam to get money? You know, nothing is still working on the site. So whatever, he got my $20. It is what it is. I was able to still kind of hear the documentary. So now what's going on is this, okay? Basically, the women of the talk are saying that Corey Feldman had no business, you know, naming the people that he named, especially Charlie Sheen. One of the women, who is Marie Osmond, she goes on to say that for her, it took her 30 years to talk about her abuse, and she didn't want to name names because she didn't want to name names because her abusers died, and she didn't want to, you know, basically shame their family and everything else. So they go on to have this discussion, and they're basically shaming Corey for telling his truth and Corey Haim's truth. So I want you guys to go ahead and listen to this really quick. And the other person who's talking on the show is guest co-host Rumor Willis, who is Bruce Willis and Demi Moore's daughter. So she's also going to chime in as well. And then also Cheryl Underwood, who is one of the regular hosts on the talk, she also chimes in as well. So I want you guys to go ahead and check this out, and I'll come back with the rest of the podcast.
Well, for me, talking about my abuse finally after 30 years, I didn't feel the need to name them because they had died. And they couldn't hurt anyone, and I didn't feel the necessity to hurt the families. Does that make sense?
Yes, it does.
I think the sad part about all this is that in Corey Haim's case, he's not here. Yeah. And when you start passing around secondhand information that's not your story, I think the only person that has a right to tell your story is you.
Agreed.
And that's kind of what I feel.
Yeah. Well said. I really agree with you. I think, first of all, as just a blanket statement, it's not okay to out somebody for whatever reason. Mm-hmm. And that's not your story. You know what I mean? If Corey Haim had decided to speak up, whether this is true or not, then that's his choice. But I think unless it's a child and you see something happening to a child to protect them, if it's not your story, it's just kind of gross to be using it in any way and to not allow someone to decide for themselves.
And
that's
even,
what they want to share.
And even a child, you don't want to out a child's story because the child can be very sensitive about it too until they're in a place to be able to talk about it.
Right.
It's a process, that whole process of healing, coming to terms with it. If you want to accuse somebody, if you don't want to accuse somebody. It's a lot of things. What do you think, Cheryl?
I just think for someone that it happened to me, the only reason I don't name names is because I don't want those who love me to avenge something on my behalf.
All right, so you guys just heard that. And so that kind of disturbed me when I hear these women sitting around and basically trying to shame Corey from not only telling his truth, but also Corey Haim's truth, okay? First and foremost, let's not forget that Corey Haim died back in 2010. So he's not here to tell his story. But what we do know is that Corey Feldman and Corey Haim have been best friends since they were like teenagers. And Corey is saying that they made a pact, and that basically Corey Haim told him that when he felt the time was right, he wanted Corey Feldman to tell his story. And you know what? If my best friend struggled with a lot of stuff and she wants me to eventually tell her story because she wasn't strong enough to tell her story and she's passed, guess who's going to tell her story? Me. Because that was my best friend and she gave me permission, and I'm feeling the need in my spirit to tell her story and get it out there. So I don't like this whole victim shaming that they're trying to pull. And Marie Osborne, yes, it's your choice not to tell your story for 30 years. You know what I'm saying? And you literally, with your silence, you protected these offenders. Because for 30 years, through you being silent and not wanting to, you know, cause the family duress and all this bullshit, you've forgotten that 30 years that you are the victim. You don't owe a molester or their family any damn thing. They violated you. They sexually assaulted you. You don't owe them any favors. And the problem is when we have this mentality that we're going to keep quiet and then tell the story after the people have died. And one thing we all know, predators never stop being predators, okay? A leopard never changes its spots. So if this person molested you, trust and believe they were molesting other people for those 30 additional years. It did not start with you, most likely, and it damn sure didn't end with you. So your silence potentially caused other people, other women, other boys to be victims of child molestation. So I'm not going to sit here and applaud you or clap or give you props because you chose to be silent because you didn't want to offend the perpetrator's family. You didn't want to put them under duress. Who gives a shit? I'm more worried about the children. So I don't agree with that. Her being silent, I got to give you the side eye. And then the fact that because you chose to be silent, you expect others to? You expect others to not tell other people's stories? No, ma'am.
Yo, what's up?
Hey, Tea Sippers. To listen to the rest of this podcast, please go to Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Google Play, Stitcher, TunedIn, or AnchorFM.com, which is a free podcasting site. Thank you guys so much for the support, and stay tuned for the next video.